I think I need to go there.
How about the offer to pay back his
restaurant?
Mr. Mallya, do you feel extradition now?
He wants to be walking to a certain place just outside the court and then we can talk to him. So, he's trying to get in front of the court. You can see the huddle that it always is when Mr. Mallya walks in.
Is it fine now, Mr. Mallya? Can we not talk?
We would like to be outside.
Mr. Mallya, aaj lagbhag ek saal ho jayega. जब आपका यहाँ पर एक्सपेडिशन केस शुरू हुआ
था,
दिस इज गुड
एनाफ। आई
एम सॉरी,
व्हाट इज योर नेक्स्ट स्टेप?
मिस्टर मालिया, क्या आप डर रहे हैं?
ओके, लेट हिम स्पीक।
लेट हिम स्पीक, प्लीज अलाउ मिस्टर मालिया टू स्पीक।
मिस्टर मालिया, थैंक यू। फर्स्ट द व्हील आस्क।
थैंक यू।
या।
मिस्टर मालिया, क्या आप डर रहे
हैं? वन सेकंड कूल अप प्लीज।
व्हाटएवर द जजमेंट, my legal team will review the judgment if required and take appropriate steps thereafter. Yes, I have tweeted saying that I want to repay the public sector banks and other creditors, employees very much included. But that has nothing to do with this extradition decision. This is a completely separate matter.
Move this mic.
And my settlement offers are not related to the judgment that will be delivered today. I have filed a comprehensive settlement application before the Karnataka High Court, which coincidentally is also being heard today. And it is in that context that I want to disprove the narrative that I stole money by offering to make a 100% settlement. So please understand the context in which I tweeted. As far as today is concerned, I've been watching with great interest all the Indian television channels this morning. And finally, you yourself have said, either which way, whatever the judgment is, what is the way forward, you've already said it. So I have nothing more to add.
I have a question.
But you're aware that your offer to pay the money back is completely independent from the extradition itself. It's fundamentally irrelevant.
So my
question is absolutely irrelevant to the extradition. You're right. It is an offer to pay back in the context of my settlement application before the Karnataka High Court.
Have you had any calls from anybody, please?
Now if you will please allow me to go into court because I do not want to be late.
So one last question. May I ask how genuine is the offer? Where will this money come from,
sir? Mr. Mallya, I'll be back to
that. 1 second, please. How genuine is your offer, sir, to pay
up? There is nothing genuine or ingenuine. Please understand, the offer has made before a court of law. Nobody disrespects a court of law by making a bogus offer.
But Mr. Mallya left the country when the Supreme Court was seized of the matter.
The assets have been attached by the Enforcement Directorate on their own admission. So they can't be bogus assets. All right? Today, those very same assets are before the court. The Enforcement Directorate and the banks are fighting over the same assets. The same assets have a value that is more than enough to pay everybody. And that's exactly what I'm focusing on.
Are you then ready, sir, for a negotiation?
The Supreme Court was negotiating on your behalf. Why did you leave the country, Mr. Mallya, in between? That's the whole point. And if you would you contest it now today? If you lose the appeal?
This is not an appeal, as you know.
I know, but will you go in for appeal?
I've heard you on the television as well.
Yeah.
You know what you're asking me today. and what you said 2 days ago in the TV, to which I responded.
Yes, you did, but there was nothing absolutely incorrect in that, Mr. Mallya.
Have you been...
Was the Christian Michel extradition, did that cause give you cause for concern?
There are so many extradition cases. Each one is individual. One cannot feed off the other. So I didn't even know about Christian Michel or his extradition when I tweeted my offer for settlement. That's the truth.
Mr. Mallya, does the situation have any impact on it? Mr. Mallya.